Hello, thank you for joining. It's nice to have everyone here. Hi, Sammy. Hello, Sammy. We are here. Thank you for coming. I'm so happy to have you here. Here comes Kana Daniel. He's here to be a special guest on the gist session. Thank you everybody for coming. Thank you for joining us. I hope we've had a lovely week so far. It's been a very busy one for me, but we've had fun all the way. We thank God for life. We thank Him for grace to be who we are. We thank Him for everything, in short, nothing else. We're going to wait for a few more people to go on with us. Kinky Praise, thank you for joining us. You're very welcome. We call this session our little gist. It's a kind of informal teaching. So hopefully we should be able to learn very plenty things from this session. Thank you, Abisola. Thank you very much. I'm blushing. See blush. I cannot see you yet. It's still trying to connect, but we can hear your voice. Oh, girl. We can hear your voice. I think maybe you should log out and come back in. Yeah, or maybe you didn't give Instagram access to your camera. So you might want. Right, like I was saying, it's generally a gist session where we learn from each other. So I am not the teacher. Ghana Dan Daniel is not the teacher. We are not teaching here. We're just deliberating and learning from each other. I would like to say that in the past few sessions, I've learned a lot from a lot of people. And maybe I'll catch you. Thank you for joining us. It's our little gist, we call it. It's just a gist session where we learn from each other. Thank you, Ayofunke, for joining us, and get better. It was Father's Day on Sunday. If you celebrated a father, can you do this? I cannot see you anyway. Doctor, we still cannot see you.
The devil
Can you log out and check your camera?
liar.
It
Okay.
might be that you didn't give Instagram access to your camera, so check the setting.
Okay. Well, I normally take
Yeah.
pictures directly from my Instagram. So, anyways, let me check again.
Check, yeah. Just check the settings generally. We are still waiting for you. Right. Welcome, Chika. You go. Thank you very much for joining. I'm happy to have you here today. Toluwa, she changed her name. Hey. She used to have a maiden name. Now she's changed it. Hallelujah. Testimony number one when we resume back to church. Tolu changed her name. Sounds like a sermon our pastor would preach. And Tolu changed her name. Right. I don't know if you can help Ghana Daniel out. Maybe you can go to the back room and see if you can help him out with the sorting of the camera. Like I was saying, it was Father's Day on Sunday. For the men in my church, we did a little surprise for them. We got them different things. My husband got like a DIY toolbox. And he loved it to bits. And they were very happy. And I was happy too because we normally just neglect them. We buy them things, but not really things. We appreciate them, but we don't truly say it. But now I think we are stepping up and appreciating the fathers because they really do so much too. So it's not about having Mother's Day 10 times a year. And posting our mother's pictures once in a while to say thank you. We've got beautiful fathers all over the world. We've got dads that are doing amazing things. We've got some of them that are so sacrificial. And that is why God has helped us to come up with this topic today. I'm still waiting for Ghana Daniel to join us. so that we can proceed from here. And while we wait for him, I'm just going to try and explain this. This is how we do it. People that have been joining us knows this. We come together and we discuss. Ghana Daniel and I will coordinate this discussion. Then you can give us your views, your ideas in the comment section. Then we talk about it. Then we go on from there. So it's like a chat and talk session. So you chat us, we do the talking, if you understand what I'm saying. Welcome, Olayiwola Fajori. Thank you for joining us. It's going to be a wonderful session today. If you don't mind, can we say a word of prayer for all the fathers all over the world, if you want to join me? Our Father in heaven, we want to say thank you for all the amazing dads you've given us in this world. We thank you for your grace upon their life. We thank you for giving them strength to be what they are towards their family, towards the community, towards the church of God, towards the glory of the Lord. Daddy, we thank you for your power upon their lives. We thank you for giving them strength to do what they do. We know that you've destined them for greatness, and we know surely that you will lead them to that place where you are taking them to. In you, they will get better, they will get brighter. The wisdom to be the dad, the father, the uncle, the grandpa, everything they need to be on earth, you will give unto them. Every father on earth, Father, Lord, they will not fail you. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we pray for the fathers that are looking forward to you for one thing or the other. You will give them what they desire, Lord. You will teach them to be father indeed. All the fathers that need to grow up, get up, improve, Father, you will send them help. You send them mentors. You send them people that will help them to be better in everything they do. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you for allowing me to pray. I love my dad to beat. So I'm on the father's side today. So nobody should come and talk about mothers celebrating in father's list. No, we are talking about the fathers today. And let me see if we can get Kana Daniel to join us again. Lola Precious, thank you for joining us. Happy to see you here. I don't know. I'm still going to wait for doctor to join us. His camera is still loading.
I don't know what's wrong with this camera. I've checked. I have settings. Everything is supposed to be fine. So I'm confused right now.
Don't worry, everything will be fine. Everything will be fine.
I guess we'll just go ahead. My voice is there. It's fine.
Mm. Yeah, that's okay. You can try and log in with another device if you've got an alternative.
No, I don't have any other device close to me right now.
Right. Then we can go on from there. Welcome. We just prayed for the Father, so you've got our own share of the prayers anyway.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Said amen. Right, we're going to be talking about work, family, and the balance. This is where we'll start. I will say a few things as a summary, then Ghana Daniel too will say something about this topic, then we can proceed from there. Like I said, we celebrated Father's Week on Sunday, and it was awesome. And I appreciate the fact that people rose up to celebrate Father's this time around, because we usually like celebrate Mother's Day like 10 times a year. Fathers have been really precious. We've got lovely fathers all over the world. We've got wonderful dads. We've got I don't know where it came from. I know mothers do a lot. Like I said, today I'm not on the mother's side. I'm going to be on the father's side today. So fathers are lovely and they are wonderful people. The strength they've got is wonderful.
Yeah.
So they've got a lot of things that they do because they are not so emotional. Some of them are not so emotional as women. They don't have to share their weaknesses with us. Whereas they've got weaknesses, they try to shuffle between work and family and other things, and they still meet up. And God is still helping them. So it's been a very growing up, watching fathers do things for their children has showed me that men are really wonderful people and they need to be celebrated, really. So I'm going to allow Canada name just to say a bit about how work and family can blend together. Then we can go from there. It's going to be really interesting today. We've got some major points to discuss about fatherhood and about their sacrifices, which we do not appreciate. So we are going to do this. Right, Canada Neil, are you there, sir?
I'm very here.
Right. Can you just go on then?
Well, work, life, and balance. I think that those are very critical things in life that we cannot do without.
Yeah.
And coming from, my cultural background, being African, we see our fathers doing a lot. I'm not saying other cultures don't do much, but our fathers, they do a lot. And when I look back and see things my parents did, especially my dad, working away, and you know, it motivates me to want to do more. Actually, work is very, very important.
Yeah.
In summary, I'll just say the way we should handle the three of work, life, and family is when you work, you work as if you don't have a family.
Yeah.
When you're with your family, you're with your family as if you don't have a work.
Yes.
So when you're playing, you also play as if you don't work. And then when you're praying, you pray as if you don't do any of those.
Right.
What I'm trying to say is that there's no place for 10% and 5% or something percent.
So it has to be 100% on all sides.
It has to be 100% on all sides.
Yeah. Before we go on with that, I would like us to go to the next point where we're going. We are going to discuss fatherhood in the past. So I want in the comment section to come up and tell us what fatherhood was in the past that people are trying to bring into this generation. What fathers have done in the past. I'm not saying we should crucify them here. I'm just saying the mistakes they have made and the things that they've not really done right, that we think they've not done right, and they're trying to bring to this generation. So I would like us in the comment section to say something about that, and we're going to go into how things have changed over the years, how fathers have kept up their game. So now I would like to start with this. I remember that in years back, fathers used to be like, I don't want to say Lord, because actually Lord, I'm just going to use another kind of thing. They used to be like the master. Wow. I don't know if anyone agrees with me here. They used to be like the one in charge of everything. So without them, you don't make decisions, which is really the right thing to do anyway. But they drive the house. They're driving slaves in those days. I don't know if anyone is getting... I don't know if everyone is getting what I'm saying. In a D, we are not there to do. How are you saying? They want me to be blushing. Right.
Well, I guess those days depends on a lot of things. Depends on the background, depends on how far we want to look back as well.
Yeah.
Because I think most of all, our parents, they were quite authoritative, but it was the reason, you know.
Yeah.
They were not. Maybe if we go back more years, maybe in the 60s or around that time, we find that the parents, the dads then, they are yes or no, you know?
Yeah.
And once it's said, it is final. Do this and you have to do it. There is no place for what about, no option.
I'm still waiting for people, sorry to cut it short though. I'm still waiting for people in the comment section. What do you think fatherhood was in centuries before ours? What do you think fatherhood, what have you read, what have you heard about fathers, what have you heard them done? Because I think not appreciating the father enough is not something that just came up. It's something that come over the years, and people have seen that fathers don't actually do much more at moms. But these days we see dads going all the way to do things for the family. So I just want us to come up, what do you think fatherhood was in past? What do you think fathers have done that made people not to really appreciate their efforts? Like from the tradition where I come from Yoruba land, fathers used to be like farmers, and they go to the farm, they plant crops, but normally they do not go with their wife except on rare cases when they want to do harvesting. So the moms just stay at home and watch the kids, cook for the house, make sure everything is in order at home. But the fathers go to the farm and make sure they plant crops. But harvest time, they go with their kids and the mother to bring the things home.
Yeah.
But this is where I'm going. Because they are not usually in the faith of the children. Even though they were farmers, they were not the ones showing the children. We are still going to get to this. We are still going to get to what triggers application in children. But I'm just saying, because they are not in the face of the children, the children see more of the moms.
Yeah.
That's why I think this thing has grown up to this level. So I'd like people in the comment section, what do you think has caused it? Why are fathers not really appreciated in the past? Why didn't people really appreciate their effort? Yeah. And Doc, over to you.
Yeah. Volume Hair, welcome.
Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, we're just talking about work, family, and the balance.
Yeah.
You know, one thing is growing up, you started appreciating what some of them did. Yes, you know, we didn't used to see them, but as you said, they're always in the farm working. So the thing on their head was just to provide for the family, and they left everything else for the mom to do. Which is important, and if you look at that, you learn one thing, the balance may not be there totally, which is now playing with your family, like playing with your kids. But looking at them, you realize that you just want to be like that. Okay, I just need to provide for my family, and that's all. Yeah. But it's actually more than providing for your family. You need to provide physically, emotionally, financially.
That was where I was going to. Yeah, it's not just about physical providence. What of the emotions? What of the care? Mm. And you know, children, it's not to them, it's not about good food. In fact, they don't know the difference between good clothes and bad clothes. Sometimes the love you show them is more than them wearing rags.
Mm-hmm.
It's more than that. Olatiyawarewa just say, I don't know what to say because I adore my father too much.
that's something. he must have done something right for you to adore him like that.
He's been an amazing dad anyway. Thank you for saying that, Olatile Warewa. Fathers need to be involved in all, not just school fees. Well, I think in a place like Nigeria, fathers believe that once they've gone to hustle, in quotes, and bring in money for the family to pay the school fees,
yeah,
get the kids, that's all. So we don't have time for laughing and playing together. I'm not saying fathers now, before people start coming and attacking me. I'm saying fathers in the past. So this is what they do. They come home, then when you hear daddy's horn from like 10 meters from the house, you know the horn of his car. You'll be like, the master is coming. Everybody will just sneak into their bed. And go and leave them, because when daddy is home, nobody appears, you know? It went on like that for a while. But when the mother comes, you see children run to her, she brings in stuff. Oh, mommy, what did you buy for her? What did you bring? She's coming from work. Mm. They expect her to bring something for work anyway. And she brings in something for the kids. She sits with them, even though she's tired, you know? I think it's very important. I think I like the fatherhood style coming up these days. Fathers are more involved in their children's life.
Yeah.
More and more than what our grandfathers, great-grandfathers did. And I think it changed the environment and it's changed the thinking of the children also.
True. And if you actually look at the definition of family, it's actually like, we can say it's a unit of society that is made up of parents and children.
Uh-huh. You know?
So it's like everybody in that unit works together, need to work together, you know.
Yeah.
So even the children have their role to play, but concentrate on us today.
Yeah. So if you are just joining us, Shewadeni, you're welcome. Thank you for joining us. We're actually talking about what Fathers in the Park does, all those the grand, great-grand, grandfathers, what they do, what made a certain generation not to appreciate fathers. What do you think could have happened in the past? What do you think you've done wrong? I know that one of the things might be polygamy. Because in past, they just have wives, and especially in Africa, they have wives, then the mothers take the responsibility from giving birth. Then it's just to make her pregnant. So every mother makes sure their child goes to school, get this, get that. And some of the fathers, you know what? If the mothers need to collect school fees for the child, she needs to do like a sacrifice.
I will not say anything.
You need to like carry sacrifice now, you know, like our Lord and personal savior. So your children need to go to school and there's no school food. You get what I'm saying? No child will say that kind of thing and say, oh, this man is a superb dad, even though he give millions as school fees.
Yeah.
Did you understand? Olatunde Wariwa just said something. She said, I think polygamy caused it too. Yeah, first wife give their children different perception about their dad. That is another level of it. Then sometimes it's up to the mothers too. I think mothers too did a lot of it. Instead of them covering up for the dad, you know, now they just say, hey, your father, don't mind, you know he will not do it. You know he will not do it. And it then gradually sow a seed in the heart of the kid.
Yeah,
and that we just grew up to say, oh, my father is just nothing, it's just a father.
Yeah, so then he said, fathers back then appeared like a fair figure.
Ah, God bless you.
And like I blame the mothers, because then when the children,
you're blaming us,
you say you're misbehaving, but let daddy come back home, let daddy come back home. So by the time daddy now comes back home, we'll flog the child for you people. And then people will go behind our back and pet the child that you asked us to flog. You know, you now set us up.
I get that, really. That can be like, oh, the fear is coming. So they don't really see the dad as part of the family. It's just somebody that comes to punish the family. Olatunde Wariwa, I just say, but then the father can prove that mothers can prove the mothers wrong too.
Yeah, they do.
But really, the words we speak for the children, it really matters a lot, because most of them just grab things and just start growing up with it.
Yeah, yeah. And I think another thing that used to happen then is that, because I think the African man or men generally, even here, they tend to hide a lot of their emotions. And then back home, they feel that, okay, as you said, I'm your almighty, I'm everything, I need to face this, I need to do that. Yeah. And they come back home. They are frustrated because maybe, I don't know, market didn't sell well or something is wrong, you know. And then they are back home and they are jumping on you and they want to do one thing or the other. You just snap. Please leave me alone. And you know.
And I can remember that before my dad started telling me love me back, it took him time. And now, Sev, he's comfortable to say it over text. Than saying when we do video call, I'm like, daddy, I love you. Like, ah, you'll be fine, all right, my girl, you'll be all right. I'll be like, no, I'll tell you.
So yeah, is that man part of kind of ego or something, or hiding the emotion?
Man part of showing emotions.
Yeah,
I get that. So it might just not be all of these factors that contributed to not celebrating fathers enough.
Yeah.
Because to me, I think they are super, super people. Like, like when we celebrate mothers, we celebrate all the mothers.
Yeah.
Even the so-called not so good ones.
Mm-hmm.
But still, we celebrate mothers. But when we try to celebrate fathers, we try to separate them. They are good fathers, they are bad fathers. But let's talk about goodies now. Let's leave the bad out of them. We've got lovely men out there. Olatunde Wariwa just said something. I'll quickly read that. She said, a lot goes on behind the scenes between dad and mom, and it indirectly reflects So it takes the grace of God not to take sides as children. That is very true. That is very, very true. That is very true. I don't know. I think children are more passionate for their moms than their dad.
Yeah.
I'm not saying all of them, but most of them. And it takes the mother to be able to make them have the same feeling for their dad. You get what I'm saying? Because naturally, they are coming to you and saying, oh, mom, you are this, you are that. Make them say that their father too is this, is that.
I think what we forget sometimes is that, as I mentioned earlier, we are emotional beings.
Yeah.
And we tend to get that emotional comfort more from your mom and from our mother. So you tend to be to side with them naturally. But myself as an example, when I was younger, probably would always side with my mom. But now that I'm, you know, when something happens and I'm just looking at them and my dad would be like, can you see what your mom is doing? I just automatically become a diplomat and then I'll start speaking grammar. At the end, nobody is wrong, nobody is right.
You won't know where to start.
Because the problem is actually that they come and attack me.
I know. We can use emotional blackmail, Ali.
Yeah.
We can really do that. right. Let's move forward from there. I'm still waiting for comments from people about the fathers in the what era can I call it though?
Yeah.
To borrow English.
I should borrow English. Let's just say back
era. So they are talking about what fathers in the past have done, and I think. Violence too might be part of it. Some kids grew up seeing their dad maltreat their mom.
True.
So some kids see their mom not having a chance to talk in the home. Let me say, for example, the father is talking and the woman is trying to explain and just saying, shut up, you cannot see anything. And she just keep quiet like that. And the child will be like, oh, this woman is not fair or not. Then you start developing the I don't know if I'll call it pity or whatever.
Yeah.
Then speak to her like, this woman is trying. She's still staying with this. And I think domestic violence or abuse in general also made children to grow up not to really love their fathers.
Yeah.
Not really appreciate father enough. But I think father in the past few years has really grown up to that level where they've seen that they need to step up. And they've really been effective in their fatherhood work. Do you understand what I'm saying?
It has really helped
to mold the community itself.
Yeah.
It's really helped. So we are talking about fathers in the past. If you are just joining us, we've talked about fathers that just provide physically and not emotionally, not in other ways. Yeah. We've talked about let me just read what volume H&B said. She said, in my village long ago, women do everything. The men sit at the waterfront all day, waiting to be fed by their numerous wives. Can you see that? Can you see that now? So those are part of the things that make people to really zero their mind that this man is not really worth celebrating. So what they do is just celebrate the women.
Wow. But that's true. There's a concern my wife mentioned to me. I can't remember that. Yeah, the women actually can go to the farms as well. So it's probably the same with what Volume H&B has said. Women do everything, you know. The men just sit down and wait. They're drinking palm wine and having hot belly and all that. So when you grow up in such setting, even the kids, that's what they end up doing. I know studies have shown. I don't know what the latest figures for the European side is, but like in America, homes that don't have father, the child is most likely, highly likely to be educated compared to where there's a father figure. And it's also highly likely to be involved in violent crimes and all that. So if what you've grew up seeing is your dad being lazy and nothing, you're not going to amount to anything in the future. And then obviously you want to continue eating good food and you see they end up being, I don't know, miscreants or something.
Yeah, Bangbulu, welcome to this chat session. We're talking about fatherhood, and we're talking about what fathers in the past have done that made me not really appreciate fathers. And from here, I want us to go to what do you think has made the difference in recent times? What has made people to change? Why did they change? Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because I know there have been a lot of changes. I could remember when I was small, my dad is a really superb man. I can say that 1 million times again. One over and over. I can say it as many times as I can. He's a very, very superb man. My dad just went against all traditions. My dad will not sit down and you go and bring him water to wash his hand before food. If you don't bring the water, he'll go to the kitchen and wash his hand. You know what typical African fathers do now? My dad will not wait for you to bring his food. Sometimes for you to come out of the room and cook. Sometimes they stay in your room and cooking today. And he will cook.
That's we're not talking about those type of fathers. He's not.
If my dad was on the somewhere and I was coming from school with my friend. And I told my friend, my dad, because normally when you're taking your friend home, you like to give them brief now. My dad will be home. He's on leave. So I briefed them, and when I got home, I was hearing somebody in the kitchen making amala. You know how amala sounds when they are making it. And my friend was like, "Is your mom at home?" And I just kept quiet. I just looked into the kitchen. I said, "Dad, let me finish it." He said, no, don't worry. I'll finish it.
Wow.
And he finished the food, served me, served my friends. And we ate amala.
and it doesn't make
him less of who he is. Do you understand what I'm saying? So there are men that have done superb things even in their generation that people look at them as, they are weak, they don't have mouth, they don't do this. Do you get what I'm saying? But now people cannot say that to you anymore because almost all men do it now. They cook for their families, they wash clothes, sweep floor, and all those domestic things that used to be left for women.
Yeah.
You just said mothers are... celebrated heroes. Fathers are unsung heroes. Yeah, we agree with you. They are like martyrs who take dagger, get bruises, and keep the farm. Yeah, I think people now tend to celebrate fathers for when they die.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying?
But why wait till then?
I know.
Yeah.
King Praise just said, now men cook for their family. Yeah.
Are you talking from experience, King Praise?
He's talking from experience too.
Yeah.
Really, if men don't cook now, they will just be hungry because even the wife has gone out to work. Women will sit at home and just be cooking food 24 hours. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah. I guess so I have to finish up.
You've got to step up your game. And cook food for yourself, or else you'll be hungry.
Yeah. No, just pulling on the point you said. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Empowerment is now a thing. So everybody's enlightened to treat each other fairly and want to set good example for their kids too.
Exactly.
Sammy 186.
Exposure to internet has cut across making the world a click away and has afforded us knowledge about other places, and we choose those that suit us. Okay, yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
That computer
opened up. Really exposed a lot of people to different things. So you've seen the side of a good father, the side of a bad father, and all sorts.
And I must say, it takes a good an open heart to actually choose. Some people, even after being exposed to all these things, they choose not to do what is right.
Yeah.
So I think kudos to those people that have seen how things should be and have decided to change. You know, change must happen, and wanting to grow makes you look for all this information and develop yourself. So you have to do all that.
I think now I'm going to go deep into this thing now. Now, to men that are Christians that are godly, what are they doing better? What do you think they should do better? Because there's always more to give anyway.
True.
What do you think they can do better to make, not to earn appreciation really, but to lay good examples and make sure that they are celebrated, even when they're alive. So I'm waiting for us in the comment session to
give
us an answer to that. You
know what I said. So men are still stereotyped. Oh, God.
On what side are you? Olatile Warewa.
I don't know. I have to private chat after this routine because but I think it's a good thing that women are doing a lot of things these days, you know. It apart from being empowered, it shows me personally, I like seeing women doing a lot of things. If a woman is driving, I love it. If I see a female pilot, I love it. If I see a female, you know, that's my nature. So it's good. It's like showing that and they are there, not just for home, you know. They can be out, they can. So if what is good for God goes is good for the gander. So if the person that's been staying home can now be running up and down the way you that was running up and down before, that means you as well can stay at home.
Yeah.
You know, so you can do laundries, you can, because she has stepped up to do what you are doing, you know. Everybody's putting effort to make this work.
I think that makes sense to me. So everybody needs to step up in it. If you can step up to your level, you two need to step up to our level.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shewa Deni just said something. He said, what a man can do, a woman can do better. The balanced exposition of this is helping men to step up.
Correct.
The narrative now is what a woman can do, a man can do better in the kitchen and anywhere. God bless
I know this will sound funny, but what I used to say when I was growing up is that there's only one thing a woman is supposed to do that a man is not supposed to do, which is to give birth and breastfeed. Any other thing, a man should do.
But not for, let me reframe that, to be pregnant, give birth, and breastfeed.
Oh, yeah, the pregnant is part of... That pregnant is very important too. Even though they are doing crazy things right now, but with science and technology, but I still think women are wonderful.
Right. We are going to Christian fathers now. So what do you think Christian fathers are doing better? I'm not saying people that go to church now, because anybody can go to church. People that really are growing in Christ, people that are walking with God. I know that we don't all just get to perfection suddenly. It's a gradual process for us.
True.
So a Christian dad that walk and run a family, you've got a ministry, definitely, that God has called us all into. So how do you think, what do you think they are doing better? Because that is more responsibility anyway. That is more responsibility.
Yeah. You know, nobody has said anything. What?
What I mean is that when any man is doing great, the other one should not only discourage him, instead they should encourage and learn as a Christian. I'm not a man, so but I've seen scenes of men like condemning each other for taking a certain step. Like, you mean your wife did that and you kept quiet? You mean this is what you did? You could have done it this way. Why are you so weak? So I think this is what Olatile Warewa is saying here, that if a man has done something extra, he should be encouraged and not discouraged.
True. But at the end of the day, I think men should also learn that there's a saying, I think I read it from Things Fall Apart Thursday in secondary school or something, I can't remember that when an agama lizard jumps from an iroko tree and nobody hails it, it looks around and nods its head. You should be your own self cheerleader, you know. I'm talking about Christian parents. We know we should be like, we should always endeavor to walk according to the Spirit and according to what is in the Word of God, you know. So even though you're doing something and it is, you know, it is right. That's what you're supposed to do. And maybe your friend now tells you that, how can you be washing plates? Is your wife not supposed to be doing that? You just look at him and laugh and say, learn how to do it. It doesn't kill. Or you wait and finish it. And now ask him, did I die? No. That means you can do it yourself. You know? So,
did I die?
Those are the ways you can challenge your friends.
Yeah. Let's go to the next thing I want us to discuss. So what triggers kids' appreciation of their dads? I'm not saying fathers should work to earn their appreciation now. I'm just saying, what can men do naturally for their kids to appreciate them? What triggers it? Because kids naturally, I don't know if you buy them things, like you buy them things, they love it, they jump about it for a week, then after that, nothing else. So what triggers the appreciation? What can you do for them as a father that will make them really appreciate your effort?
Yeah. Before we continue, I'll just read Volume H&B's comment. I think men are more in church activities compared to previous times, so they hear the same messages as their wives. And that's true. Back in those days, these mothers always go to church, you know.
Yeah, it's only the women that usually go to church and listen to whatever the pastor is saying.
Yeah. Hence the better preparation. Kiki praise. A Christian father should be the priest in his home. I love that. You should not be something in your home and another thing outside or in the church. So basically, the first church is the home.
Yeah, that is the main church, my brother.
The first church is the home. So basically, in fact, the other day I got so angry with my son, and I can't remember my dad doing this like this, and he's just going to be 8. I got very angry with him, and I said very hurtful words to him. And after 2 hours, after he had finished crying, I went back to where he was and I sat down with him and I talked to him and I called him and I apologized. I said that I'm not supposed to talk to you like that. That was very, very wrong. And then he looked at me and then he started crying and then I hugged him. I said, is he okay? He said, yes. I said, I'm sorry, okay? He said, yeah, that's fine. I said, will you hug me? Now hug me. You know? And I just, after that, he just became very happy and he was jumping all around, you know. So we have to be an example for them. We cannot, you know, say something else and...
Can I come else. In now? Like, yes, please. Like men of the past, they don't apologize.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
They do not apologize. They mm-hmm. don't. They hardly apologize. Mm-hmm. Men in the past hardly. But I think because men that we know are now Christ-like, they are growing with Christ and they are learning. Mm. They've learned to throw away that ego. And now they are coming down to the level of the child.
Yeah.
That's one thing my dad did and is still doing till today. Apologies. Yeah. He is superb in that. If he has done something wrong and he has seen that he has done something wrong, he will not just zero his mind and say, oh, I've done it, I'm the dad and I can get away with this. He just come back to me and said, what I said the other time, I'm sorry. And I don't see it happening to a lot of people. I've been to my friend now, and his dad said he stole something while we were there, and he found it later, and he just walked away. I'm like, if it was my dad, he would almost cry, like, oh, I'm really, really sorry. So I think
my dad will hardly. I can't remember. Maybe he has, but I can't remember. One of the way my dad apologizes, if he just say, oh gosh. And then, or you say, oh my gosh. And are you, oh God, who's that man?
I think fathers are just getting better and super now.
Yeah.
I think they're just getting better and super. So it's like we've said from the beginning, we are going to go to that trigger, but like we said, I just want to give a brief recap, like we said from the beginning, if you're a father, you should not just provide physically.
True.
You should provide spiritually, emotionally, mentally, morally.
Yeah.
So these are the things that really makes the kids to really appreciate what you do. It's not about buying them clothes and shoes.
True.
They can run around with them without them anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So can we go to what triggers kids to really appreciate their dad now?
Kiki
Like,
Praise. Kiki Praise is laughing. She's actually my sister-in-law.
oh, bless
So she knows what I'm talking about.
her. I think Egu just said something. Said if the father is the priest, should be the first learn to control his mouth. He should first learn to control his mouth. If you have to praise them, bless them. Do not talk anyhow. It is very important. It is very, very important because fathers are usually like me. My kids, I don't know if I was there, respect my husband more than me. If he sits them down and talk to them, they listen more than they'll listen to me. I think it's because we play too much. But him, he will sit them down like adults. Sometimes I'm like, they cannot even understand what they are saying. But guess what? They understand perfectly. He talks to them like adults. He will sit them down and he will be analyzing things. I'll be like, these kids are just looking at you like, Dad, what are you saying? But at the end of the day, they understand everything he's saying. And he has said many times that he prefers to relate with them on that level.
Yeah.
Because he doesn't want them to grow up with a child mind alone. He wants them to get wiser and better in everything. So I think it's important that fathers have a good rapport with their kids.
Yeah.
I know men don't talk a lot, but sometimes kids just want to talk.
Yeah.
They just want to talk and talk and talk and talk and talk. And talk. Mm-hmm, sometimes I'm like, I don't want to hear again, but just I'm pressing my face. Like, Mommy, are you listening? I'm listening. I'm listening. But father, like, are you done? Or before you start, they say, what? Then that's the end of the conversation.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? So they want to talk more and more. Can you go on, sir?
Yeah.
We are talking about, let me quickly brief people so that they can come up in the comment section.
Okay.
We are talking about what can, what did I call that in again? Trigger the kids to really appreciate their father. What do kids really appreciate? This is where we are. Why is mother not celebrated? What has she done that the father has not done? So we are waiting for comments from our viewers to tell us this. Welcome, True Edu. I think I know who that is.
Well, I as we said earlier, and I guess a lot of people are changing these days, and as I said, we're getting more knowledge and all that, and trying to do things differently. No one is perfect. The only person that is perfect is Jesus Christ. So anybody that thinks is perfect at this age and is not moving, even though you have the Holy Spirit, you can make mistake because you're still flesh. So if you feel you're above mistake, that means that when you do things wrong, you'll not even go back on what you have done. You just have that, I've done it the right way. Even though you do the right thing, it might even be wrong in the presence of God. Because that's not what God wants you to do at that time. So even if you should apologize to God, you might, you know. So, but once we keep learning these days, we show that to our children, and then they begin to see it, you know.
Yeah.
And then I think we are more conscious of, now we know that our parents were playing behind the scene.
Yeah.
So we now know what they were doing, and we appreciate. I can remember, like my dad, when we were growing, he used to tell me every time that, put off the light. You don't need, when you don't need it, the sun is shining everywhere, it's bright. Put off the light. And I'm like, Daddy, why? The room is a bit dark. He's like, no. And I just realized that every time now I'm telling my son the same thing. And I'm like, now I know what Dad used to say that. He's like, no, if you don't need it, put it off. You know?
Put it
so
off.
Now we have put ourselves in their shoes. So we now, because we are more enlightened, we now know what they did in the past. Yeah. Sorry, someone just said something there.
Olaiwola Fajorin just said, that's my husband. She said, fathers are now bonding the more with their children, and children tend to appreciate us. Mm-hmm. Let them know when you are serious and when you are playing. I think it's very, very important too. Yeah. That will like create the line between correction and just staying that way. It's very important that our kids, as fathers, your kids should have this bonding with you. Then at the end of the day, speak words of encouragement, praise them where you are meant to.
Mm-hmm,
which is very important. one of the things fathers don't do in the past, like we've talked about fathers in the past, is that when you do well, they don't say you do well so that it doesn't get into your head.
True.
Do you get what I'm saying? So they'll be like, oh, that way you've done, your mates are doing more than that, so you, that means you have to step up.
True. True.
Do you get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm, so mm-hmm. I think fathers have left that level and like, my son, you are really good. You've done perfectly well. I'm proud of you. I'm really proud of you. And it doesn't mean that it will get into their head anyway, but that was their perspective in those days. And some of them don't like praising their kids sometimes, maybe because the other people will feel jealous or they will feel intimidated.
Mm.
So they don't want to tell their kids they are doing better so that it won't feel it's better than the other kids. Just myself anyway.
Yeah. Well, I guess it's also about the, that they want you to keep doing the best and don't want you to relax, you yeah. know. So keep telling where you can do better, you know. You can do better than that.
I was watching a video of a little girl on Father's Day that said something about her dad. And I'm like, what a dad. She spoke about, she didn't even say anything about the man buying her anything. She spoke about the fact that when he's driving and she's talking, that he listens and they drive all the way from school. Then when she's back home, so she puts her in the shower. And she just went on and on with relational things. It's not even about gifts now. And I'm like, what a father. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So it's not about, oh, at least you are eating in this house. I'm providing you food. I don't want to say like it's coming to my head now of those days when some dads will say such thing. And now, we've spoken about some things. I'm still waiting for people in the comment section to tell me in particular what can trigger a child to appreciate the dad. Like, what can you do? What can be the trigger? I know it's not about buying them Nintendo Switch. They only say thank you for that. At the end of the day, like, my dad don't do anything in the house. My dad is just there. Do you get what I'm saying, Doc?
Yeah. So, sorry, just my kids that came to.
It's all right. It's all right.
Let me finish. I'll come meet you now.
All right. Malafajori just said something. But most importantly, let the fathers yield themselves to the leading of the Spirit. We can't raise by ourselves. I guess the thing, we can't raise the kids by ourselves, which is very important. Like we've always said on this lesson, kids are not slaves. And the only one that can help us to raise them according to his standard and his purpose for their life is God. Olatile Warawa just said something. When they take good care of their mother and be involved in all, okay, when the men take care of their mother, I think one of the things that make him a good man is when he watch his dad adores his mom. It really makes a good man. When a child, a boy, is watching his dad adoring his mom every day, honoring his mom every day, he's going to end up being the best. This has been proven over and over time.
Yeah.
It has.
If you see, sorry for cutting, if you see the way your dad loves your mom, it even triggers, you now know how you should actually treat, know, your future partner. And just to comment about all areas of life that was mentioned, that includes going to school, going to their sports day, being the one shouting the most, maybe embarrass them a bit and be the number one cheerleader or something.
I know.
Yeah.
How I used to see my dad growing up, I believe my dad can do anything.
Wow.
So my dad is an accountant, he's an auditor, and they will give us physics assignments. And I'll be like, I'll tell my friends in school, we've tried it in school, we've looked at all the key points, all the textbook, we can't solve it. I'm like, don't worry. Tomorrow, I am bringing the workings from my dad directly. And I've told them, And I'll just get to my dad. Daddy, I have one question and it's very difficult. I'll just put it in front of him. He just came back from work. He's tired. He's like that. Yeah. He just look at him and bring your test. My dad will study to solve my question.
Wow.
Because he's not into physics. Like he said, when they were in school, the way they taught them, they did a bit of everything.
Mm.
So you only have, like, you know, when you have a knowledge about something.
Yeah.
So he will tell me to bring Okeke. He will study this textbook. Then he will solve my question for me.
Yeah.
That was the length he went through.
Mm-hmm.
So he wasn't just saying, oh, I don't know it. Because I don't know, maybe he saw that it would break my heart, or maybe he saw that I had already made mouth in school, like, my dad, almighty, anything he can solve. You know?
Yeah.
And it really helped me and made me really adore him. Mm-hmm. It's not that I'm growing up, I now started thinking that this man really didn't know this thing. He will study for it. Sometimes if it's a weekend, he will tell me, don't worry, just put the book in my room. He will look at it, then solve the questions for me.
A bottle of Coke for your daddy.
I will drink that on his behalf. He cannot drink Coke, sorry.
Shall I deliver the message? Oh, dear. And it's those examples and those things are what, you know, creates that bond, which is very important.
Yeah.
Those things you do for them, that extra mile, you know. Those little things that you feel you might want to overlook, you know, even giving them their food, you know, I'm hungry, not waiting for the mom to cook for them or something.
Yeah.
All those little things, it helps bonding a lot. So,
But cooking together with them, mm-hmm. doing things with them, I think it makes them see your weaknesses. Like my son, he was trying to put a plaster on his dad's hand because they were doing something together and something caught his hand. I was like, what's wrong with the hand now? He said, no, I should not touch it. That he injured his hand. It's because he was cleaning this place and he injured. I was like, calm down. We all clean every day. Do you understand? Mm. But I think it has helped him in a way to say that, so because he was doing this, he was injured. But most of the time, in the past, you see your mom getting injured doing things. You don't even see the weakness of your dad at all. Because even when he gets injured, he won't let you see it.
True.
So I think little things like that trigger them to really appreciate their fathers.
Yeah.
And Mike just said something. She said, I hope your teacher is not ill. She might want to come out.
Oh dear, that's funny.
I know now.
I've also had that type of experience with my dad. You know, I didn't even know he could do all the work, and he just looked at it. He came back from work, and I'm like, oh. And I looked at him. I was like, so you know how to do all these things? Why have you not been teaching me? He just looked at him and was like, no, you just need to. I should read it. It's just English, you know.
Yeah.
Instead of explaining it to me, I was like, So this man knows book like this, you know? And I actually told him, I said, it was like I was a teacher before. I was like, you know? So, but well, I still remember that experience clearly and how you just explained everything to me.
Yeah.
But nobody is remarking my work, Sister Choma Ike.
And I think another thing that is coming to my head now is that the sacrifice of the father, they hide it under the mothers. So now let's say there's no food in the house and the father says, I'm not going to eat. You and the kids, you can eat.
True.
But the kid will now ask the mom, is daddy not eating? No, your daddy has eaten. He's fine. He has eaten. But he has not really eaten anything.
Mm-hmm,
but because they don't want to show his weaknesses or they don't want the kids to know. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's true.
So they only see their mom sharing the food with them. Like, this woman is eating small food. But they don't see the fact that the dad has not even eaten anything.
True.
But because you've told them he has eaten, then he has eaten.
That's true.
I think the sacrifices are more like under the moms. They just hide it in a way. Yeah.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Like now, I do most of the shoppings for the boys. I buy their things. This thing will log us out, but we'll log back in so that we can finish this session.
Okay.
It will log us out in a minute.
In a minute. Okay.
I'll continue after. Let's just wait for it to cut off now. Don't go away. There's still one more point I want us to talk about
Okay.
before we finish. I'm not going to take your time. Fashion Omisegun, we are logging.